and run over. though, at that much. And as you can see, I cut the firewall just about completely off. I've added an S&W front clip kit. I'm not real happy about it. I mean, the quality is fairly good, but I'm not real happy because of, one factor. It takes the early style Pinto stuff that's real hard to get a hold of. And number two, the craftsmanship on one piece, nothing left to be desired. I still have to put some more outriggers. They're probably going to be 2x2 outriggers so that the floor won't be quite as spongy. Plus, I've got to run them so that across so I can put my transmission tunnel in. This stuff there you won't see because the floor will be flat on top of it. But, you know, if you look real close, you can see the rear end under it and see some of the rear suspension. Of course, the garage is tight, so I got to have everything just sitting in here. Well, this is kind of a junkyard here, but most of it at least is accountable. But that's the oil pan motor. That's the steering column with what's left of the firewall that attached it. Those are the tray. That's my new plasma cutter. Boy, that is the neatest tool I think I've ever seen. Welder. Really been a good MIG. I mean, it took a long time to get it figured out and make it work right. I'm happy with it now. Right here is what's left of a Mustang 2 front end that was delivered by the junkyard so I can get the pieces off of it. I can't use the steering rack, and I just hope to God the spindles will be okay. Dark, and everything is painted black. You can get a rough idea of what the rear suspension does look like. You know, you need to have the doors be able to be removed, just like that. But that's what she looks like. Okay, this is where I'm at so far. As you can see, I've got quite a bit done to the front end. The motor plate essentially is done, except for cleaning it up and making it look better. Everything fits good. I put brackets off of the subframe connectors to rework that. The steering rack is just sitting there. It's not doing anything right now. I just got the tie rod ends modified so that they actually fit on it. If you look real close here, you can see where I've made one by one material, and I've done the shape of the the transmission bell housing. And now I can't do that, so I'll shut it off for a second. Somehow battery runs out. If you look in here, these members that I put in are just, you know, basically the tops are welded in now. The seat will mount to them. The seat does move back and forth at this point anyway. I've got to weld in a lot more, you know, one by one material so that I can make the aluminum floorboard and make it so that I have something that I can bolt the firewall to, which will also be aluminum. But that's where I'm at so far. You know, things are coming along. Off of my fuel cell. My fuel cell has been raised up in the body about 8 inches, I guess. Among this mess right here, the silver things are the headers for the car. These are hand-made headers by me. I think I did a pretty good job on them. You can't see a whole lot of them, but you can get an idea, you know, of all the welding and all the bends that were welded together in them. You can see the steering, that's a Wilwood steering rack special. And that's a steering shaft that runs up to a universal, runs up to, you know, through another shaft into the steering column, and these are all, you know, racing parts. And then that in turn runs up to where the steering wheel goes in. Also, the chrome thing that sits on the fender, or on, not on the fender, but on the frame right there, is the line lock. That's what allows me to lock up the front wheels and do a burnout. You can see down in there, I can see it normally, but right now it's kind of dark. But I've set the car up so if it does happen to run super gas, it'll have the safety equipment. I have two drive shaft safety loops.
I'm going to be